Good morning everyone, I'm Parvati from Christian College of Physiotherapy. So today I'm here to say some few things about poliomyelitis. Poliomyelitis or polio is a virus infection of the cranial nerve nuclei in the brainstem leading to temporary or permanent paralysis of the muscles that they activate. The virus affects children under 5 years of age. Causes: poliomyelitis is caused by the infection with a member of group enterovirus known as poliovirus. This group of RNA viruses colonize the gastrointestinal tract. Mode of transmission: the spread is mainly by fecal contamination route and by droplet infection. Clinical features: the course of the disease is divided into 4 stages. First one is pre-paralytic stage. This starts within few hours to a few days of duration, usually up to 3 days of duration. Signs and symptoms of this stage: headache, sore throat, malaise, constipation or diarrhea, slight cough, joint pains, backache, pyrexia of variable duration and severity, mild neck stiffness and irritability. Second one is acute stage, 3 to 6 weeks from the onset of poliomyelitis. Signs and symptoms: muscle tenderness is the most important sign seen during this stage. Third one is convalescent stage, duration 3 months. Signs and symptoms: first, spinal type, the lower limb muscles are more often involved, flexion contractures of hip, knee and equinus deformity of the ankle are common. Second is bulbar type. The most important sign of bulbar paralysis is the inability to swallow due to pharyngeal paralysis. Both swallowing and respiratory muscles are affected. Third type is post-encephalitis. In this, mental disturbance, coma, paralysis of facial muscles, symptoms similar to meningitis like headache, vomiting may occur. Fourth stage is stage of recovery. This stage extends for almost 2 years, thus the muscle in the polio patient can be strengthened to their maximum capacity up to 2 years. Diagnosis: it can be recognized by its symptoms, and to confirm diagnosis, lumbar puncture, viral culture of stool, throat or cerebrospinal fluid, reverse transcriptase polymerase chain reaction of blood or cerebrospinal fluid, serological testing for poliovirus serotypes. Prevention of poliomyelitis: passive immunization and polio vaccine are used. Complication: equinus foot, bone fracture, osteoporosis, compression neuropathy, urinary tract infection, pulmonary edema, myocarditis. Individuals who have recovered from polio may show some additional symptoms like muscle weakness and extreme fatigue called post-polio syndrome. Treatment of poliomyelitis: there is no cure for polio. The focus of modern treatment is on providing relief of symptoms, speeding recovery and preventing complications. Medical management: antibiotics to prevent infection in the weakened muscles, analgesics for pain. PT management: first one is acute stage. Correct positioning and handling technique should be followed. The child should not be lifted by one hand. While carrying the child, the hip should be in extension without any abduction. Correct positioning and splinting. Gentle passive movements. Second one is convalescent stage. Continuous splintage like above knee splint or below knee splint. Stretching of contractures. Stimulation and facilitation technique can be followed. Last one is stage of recovery. In this, various strengthening techniques like sensory integration, resisted exercise with springs and pulleys, hydrotherapy and suspension therapy, mat exercises can also be followed. Thank you.